Hi, I'm Manu Letellier and I run the Sushi School. At the Sushi School, we train and certify chefs from all around the world how to make great sushi. As a part of this, we need and we use a lot of wasabi, but we use the real wasabi. And there is only one place in Europe where they grow wasabi, and this is in the south of England, in a secret location. And that's where we are today. So come with me and I'm going to introduce you to my wasabi dealer, the real wasabi farmer, John. Come. Hey, John, you all right?
Manu, how are you doing?
I'm good, John, you okay?
Welcome, nice to see you.
It's good to see you again. Well, it's the first time I come to the farm. I have to say it's pretty amazing.
You like it?
Quick question, what are we looking at here?
We're looking at 8-month-old wasabi plants here.
So not ready to
me? We won't be pulling these out today.
Okay, cool. So how long do you need to wait?
We need 2 years. 2 years before we're going to get you a nice, big, fat rhizome for grating.
Now, in terms of water, I can see you've got loads of water. Tell me, how do you grow it? Well, don't take me all your tricks, but tell us how
this
do you grow
it. This is mineral-rich spring water bubbling naturally up out of the ground. Comes out at the top of the bed, flows naturally through, there's a slight gradient, brings the water down through the beds as it flows past the plant. It's picking up nutrients, minerals, and a little bit of oxygen that it needs to turn it into a healthy plant.
Tell me, why do you have this? Is that for the shade?
This is to protect us, yes. It's shade from the English summer
sun. Are you crazy?
No.
Come on, man, you don't need shade.
Big leaf wasabi plant needs to have not too much light intensity. Too much light, the plant's not going to be happy. It's used to growing by a mountain stream, big trees above, canopy of shade, so it's developed big leaves to grab as much light as it can.
Okay.
Overdose the light, unhappy plant.
Fair enough. Unhappy plant, unhappy menu.
Unhappy menu. Don't want that.
Okay, cool. Well, I tell you what, I would love you to go and get us a root. John, let's go. John is going to go and get us a root, and then I'm going to show you how to grate it to get the most out of it. Wasabi takes 2 years to grow, and when you grate it, you only get the flavor for 20 minutes. So both are very, very important. Let's go.
Here we go. This is what we're looking for.
Nice. Okay. Nice and big.
Nice and big. 2 years old. And if we have a look down in here, we should. You see that?
That's
what we're looking for.
Nice.
Big rhizomes.
Cool. Jack, can we take it out?
That one's fit for grating. Yeah, it's yours.
Let's go. Cool. Let's get you do it. I'm not.
I'm going to get in there.
Nice. Wow, man, that's massive.
Yeah.
So that's the whole thing. How many rhizomes do you have on that?
We got 1, 2, 3, 4 rhizomes on there.
I thought it was another one rhizome per plant.
Look at them.
Nice. That's a lot of wasabi. Now, usually I only get this from you, which is the rhizome.
That's the rhizome.
The swollen bulb.
Correct.
Yeah? Now, I don't know if you know, but you probably know that, but with the roots, they usually, you know, when you buy like fake wasabi, the powder stuff, this is the 2 to 10% of wasabi that they put in it. So they grate that and they then put it in there and place it as wasabi, when in fact the real flavor comes from the rhizome. So don't be fooled. If you want the good stuff, get the real stuff.
So that's ready for me now?
Yep, that's yours.
You pass it over?
Okay.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Thank you. Nice. It took you 2 years literally to grow that.
Yep.
So you trust me with
it,
yeah?
Look after it.
Okay, I will look after
it.
John, thank you very much for everything.
You're welcome, Manu.
And let's go and grate it. Now I'm going to show you how to take care of this and how to capture the real wasabi flavor. Come with me at the table. Whoop, let's go. See you, John. Thanks a lot, mate.
See you.
Nice, very nice. Cool. Well, we now have our full wasabi plant with the rhizome, the stems, the leaves, and that looks amazing. Now, wasabi originally was used in Japan a long time ago to preserve fish and to prevent fish from rotting. So it has very strong antibacterial properties. But I'm talking about the real wasabi, and this is what we have today. But don't get fooled. What you get and what you buy in shops and what you get at the restaurants is not real wasabi. It's a mixture of horseradish, mustard, and e-numbers to make it green. So it's completely different. The flavors are just completely different. It's really two different products. In terms of the powder, you get it in powder form, you add a bit of water, this is the powder, and you can also get it in tube like this, but this is like the worst you can get. Lots of chemicals are added to it to give it the right consistency. So if you want real wasabi, just get this, get the real stuff. Now, you'll get most of the flavors by grating it properly, and this is what I'm going to show you now. Okay, so in order to grate wasabi, you cannot use any old grater. If you were to take this rhizome and just chop it off or chew on it, you wouldn't feel anything. It needs to be really finely grated to get the right consistency, and this is where the compounds mix together and you get the wasabi flavor. Now, in order to achieve that, you have to use specific graters. Ceramic grater is great for home use. You can leave the rhizome on, it makes a lovely centerpiece on the table. Very useful, but not so much in an industrial kitchen where it can break. So I would rather use instead the steel grater. Steel grater comes in two sizes, the big one for the big rhizomes, and the smaller one at home is actually quite nice. So today I'm going to use that one just to show you how to grate it properly. To do so, you just need to grate it in a circular motion. Don't put too much pressure on it, be gentle and grate over it and over and over and over again. If you do that, you'll achieve an amazing wasabi flavor. Take a look. Take your grater like this, hold it on your chopping board, hold your wasabi root like a pen, effectively. Then, in a very slow circular motion, you're going to start grating it. But you have to make sure that you don't apply too much pressure. If you apply too much pressure, it's going to grate too fast and you're not going to release the flavors. So a very small circular motion is very, very, very important. The finer the grater, the better your wasabi will be. Now, you see that on here and on there, I still have the skin on. And the skin is very important. All the big wobbly bits have been taken out, but the skin contains also a lot of flavor. Now, this wasabi here grated is okay, but it's not kind of the right consistency yet. So you need to make sure that you carry on grating over it. And what you're looking for is really the silky paste. And you'll see it. The more you grate, the silkier it becomes. And this is when you've got your real wasabi. So let me just demonstrate again. So you're grating your wasabi in a slow circular motion. What you're really trying to achieve is a silky paste. So be gentle with it. Circular, circular, circular. Once you've grated enough wasabi for yourself, then transfer it onto your plate. When it is transferred onto the plate, you need to let it rest. You need to let it rest for 5 minutes. This is when the flavor, the unique flavor of wasabi, really develops and grows. After that, you've got a 20-minute window to enjoy it at its full, at its peak. This is really when it all comes out, when the real wasabi taste is there. So 20 minutes. Now, if you don't use all your wasabi, you can store it, and it stores very, very easily. Just keep it in the fridge, in the muslin cloth that it came with, and rinse it every 3 to 4 days, but keep it wet in the fridge, and you'll store it for a long time. Now, what I do is I grate it all. I grate it, grate it, grate it, and then I take the paste, put it into little parcels in cling film, and up in the freezer. When you need it, just take it out, defrost it, mix it again, and it's ready to use if you wait 5 minutes. Remember, this is when all the magic happens. Okay, now, if you want to enjoy fresh wasabi at home, you can get the plant. It is lovely. Look around me, it's beautiful. You can get the plant, but if you're in a hurry, you kind of have to wait 2 years. So I suggest you just get the rhizome itself. You can grate it, freeze it, enjoy it. Now, I hope we covered pretty much everything. John showed you how wasabi is grown. I showed you how to grate it. And there are literally 1,000 ways and recipes on how to use it. So get yours and go and enjoy it. Come on, go, go, go. And let us know. Bye-bye.